Hello everyone, welcome to 100 day challenge on block based coding. So this is my first video, so I'm starting this first video to just teach you how to draw the polygon programmatically. Okay, so polygons are something which has closed figure. Okay, so they are closed figures and they are two dimensional basically. Okay, and all the angles inside this polygons makes 360 degree. Okay, so let me just show you that. Okay, so like triangles is a polygon, square is a polygon, they are called as a regular polygon. Okay, so in this class I'm just going to show you how to draw a regular polygon. Okay, and square and pentagon, okay, hexagon, okay, and it goes on. Okay, as the size increases, the names will also get changed, and it goes on, the list goes on for the regular polygon. Okay, so triangle has 3 sides and square has 4 sides, pentagon has 5 sides and hexagon has 6 sides, and it goes on. You have 7 side, 8 side, everything I'll show you. Okay, and all the angles inside the triangle, I mean if you just add all the angles inside the triangle, it just contribute to 360 degree. Okay, so let me just show you that. Okay, so here it is. So if you just consider this triangle, okay, let's consider this is a triangle, and let us consider A, B and C. This is the 3 angles inside the triangle. So if you add all the 3 angles, it just contribute to 360 degree. And also for your information, all the 3 angles are equal. So instead of naming it with the different letters, let me just name with the same letters. Okay, so like this. So all the, if it is a regular polygon, then all the sides are equal. Let us consider that way. So which means A plus A plus A, you just don't consider this, okay, which is 360 degree, or you can consider 3A plus 360 degree. Okay, so what is A is equal to 360 degree divided by 3. So A is equal to 120. So if you just see here, this angle contributes to 120, here also 120, here also 120. Okay, so can you see from the sides, okay, how many sides? 3 sides. From the sides we can just derive a angle. Okay, and just see for the square. Okay, so all the angles are equal in the square and all the sides are equal. So regular polygon, okay, A and 4A, okay, 4A is equal to 360 degree. Okay, and A is equal to 360 divided by 4, it gives you 90. Okay, so if you just draw a line, and if you have a pen and compass, then you just see it, mark a 90 degree in your protractor and just draw a line, and from here 90 degree, and from here 90 degree, so you will end up in a square. Okay, so what we do in the practical geometry is same what we are doing in the coding. Okay, so we have a formula to derive the angle. Using the single angle, we are just going to a straight line, and we are just going to turn it, and again straight line, again turn for the angle, straight line, again turn for the angle, straight line. This is how we are going to do. Okay, and without getting detail, let me just take you to the scratch window. Okay, so if you are new to the scratch window, I'll be just introducing the scratch window components daily one by one. Okay, like today, let me just tell you, this is the where white space where pen is standing. So this space is called as stage. Okay, so this is first learning for you. This is called as stage. Okay, so once you see my video, you will get to know what are all the other components also. Okay, and here comes the coding. Okay, let me just explain you the coding. So when the flag is clicked, okay, so when the flag is clicked, my pen got up, which means you're not going to draw or write anything. Okay, just consider how it says. Okay, and pen size is 40 degree, which makes I just make my pen size smaller, because before it was a little bigger. So to make it reasonable size, I make it smaller. Okay, and what I say is, I want to say to glide to x and y position, which is 0 and 0. Okay, and here is a lesson for you. So all the point, I mean all the point in the stage is denoted by x and y values. Okay, like you have this is, if you want to go here, then you have x and y value. Okay, you can just put x and y value here, and your sprite, okay, this is generally called a sprite. Okay, I'll teach you what a sprite in later. Okay, it goes here, this pen goes here. Okay, so if I give 0 and 0, it comes here. Okay, and also there is a simple way to take x and y values. Okay, you no need to enter also. I'll also tell that in the future classes. Okay, and erase everything, okay? Even if I draw something before, I want to erase everything, okay? So what happens is when I just click the flag, see here, this flag, this is the start point of the animation or game. If I click this, what happens is it just take the pen out of the paper, that is out of the stage, and set the size smaller if it is bigger. Even if it is 40%, then it leaves, okay? And glide, it just glide to 0 and 0. So glide is something, it just go like a skating, okay? It just go like this. And erase everything, which is if we have something before, okay? And what happens is you have to just click on the space key, okay? So once you press the space key, what it does is it asks for this, now enter the size of the polygon, yes? So we have, I have given you a clear explanation for the size of the polygon. So it just asks for the polygon and wait. So it will wait until you enter the answer, okay? Once you enter the answer, it just repeat the process, okay? Just see here, I just give the answer as 3, okay? Let me just go and work out for you. Yes, okay, let me just pull it up here, okay? So my answer is 3, okay? So let me just do what the program does. What it does, it just do pen down, okay, which means it just draw, okay? And what happens is move 100 sip is simple. It just draw a horizontal line like this, like 100 point, you can say, okay, 100 point on the scratch window. And what happens is it turns 360 divided by answer, okay? So let us calculate what is that. 360 divided by answer is 3, which is 120 degree. So it turns 120 degree, like it turns this way, okay? This is the 120 degree, you can check your protractor. Then what happens is, it just draw 100 point, okay? Because it is in the loop, okay? So once this is done, so it just goes again, pen down, and just move 100 step, okay? So once the 100 step is done, it again turns 120 degree, okay? So one turn 20, then again, sorry, so again it just draw 100 steps, okay? So again it just draw 100 steps and turn 120 degree, and now it just stop turning because we have to repeat for the number of answer times, okay? Since the answer is 3 and we have done all the way, the final answer you get is this triangle, okay? So this is how your program works, okay? So now see here, let me just click the flag. Since everything is okay, I'm just pressing the space key from my keyboard, okay? And it just asks, enter the size of the polygon. I just give 3 and I just give enter. So can you see, it just draw this line and here and just it is done, okay? Since 3 only, it just repeat for the 3 times. So the first time it just draw and turn. And the second time, you just draw and turn. And the third time, draw and turn. And that's it. Okay. So now let us enter some more. Let me just enter the space key. Like, let me give 6. Can you see hexagon? Okay. So now see here, the interesting part is I have just forgot to mention. Like, if I just click the flag, everything goes off. So see here, I just stop it and everything goes off. Like, we have drawn hexagon, it just goes off. Okay, now I just press the space key and give 8, which is octagon. Okay, sometimes if it go like this, okay, because of the size, okay, you may just adjust the size to little bit 70. And also I would like to tell you what is the size, okay. So now if I just give 8, okay, this is perfect, okay. So sometimes if the angle and the size is okay, so the line, the centimeter line you draw on the paper and this moved 10 steps or 70 steps is similar. Okay, if you adjust little bit by trial and error method, it will work. Okay, so most basically for 10 sides, okay, for 10 sides, 70 is perfect. I'll show you that. Okay, once I click the flag, everything goes off. I just click on the space and give 10. Okay, so it is not working, then not a problem. Okay, I'm just giving 9. So 9 is perfect, till 9 is perfect, okay? So if you want to just draw for 10, 11, 12, and then you can just reduce the size to make it to fit and to make a closer shape, because a polygon is already as a closer figure, right? So to make it, you can just make the step size little lower, okay, and this step size also decides how big your diagram is. Okay, if you give lower step size, then the diagram is little lower. Just see here, if I just give something like 20, the same thing will be little lower. Okay, like if I just give 4 sides, can you see the square is little smaller? Yes. And similar way, if I give something like 50, okay, and I give flag and I give press and 4 sides, can you see the square got little bigger? Okay, the step size also decides how big your polygon should be. Okay, and that's all for this particular video. If you have any doubt, do let me know in the comment section or anywhere. I'll be happy to help you out. Okay, we'll meet you in the next 100-day challenge on block-based coding. Till then, take care. Bye bye.